Have you guys seen Peter McKinnon's awesome time travel app video? And today I'm showing you how to do that effect by yourself. Hey, what's up, buddy?
Hi!
Whoa!
Okay, so as you might have seen in Peter McKinnon's video, this is the effect and it's called, as marked in his text, Nightcrawler effect or teleportation effect or even time travel effect. And what we have to do, we are going to open a new event first, then a new project, 25p, 1080p. You can do this also in Premiere or in other editing programs. I am doing it in Final Cut Pro. First, I'm going to import the footage and the sound effects. This is going to be actually a very short or a very fast tutorial because it's not very complicated. So this is my footage I shot today. Me on a street, filming it first without me, then going into the scene, and this was the one which looked good. So what I'm doing now, I'm selecting the frame just coming down, and then just let me turn on the sound. Okay, this was me jumping. Okay, and this point, when I'm lifting the head, I will choose to cut it again. And then, again, when we have the empty street, maybe I will take the same empty street scene from after the shot, place it before the shot, cut out the first, which I don't need anymore. Okay, until there. That's good. Okay, so now I have the empty street scene first, then the cut, me jumping down, and there again the cut. This was one frame, lifting the head, and empty street again. Okay, now I have to cut again before the shadow comes in. And this would it look like with just the cuts. Okay, now I'm taking these two layers, put them over the other footage, and changing the blend mode from normal to Silhouette Luma. The other one as well. You could use other blend modes as well, you can test a little bit, but this is the one which looks most realistic. And then you can see here is a jump, so here's a cut. I will take the first layer and put it just over my head or the upper body, make it a little bit smaller for now. Maybe a little bit bigger. And then the other one, the same. But on my legs. And this is what it would look like. Looks good, but a little bit too long. So I'm going to shorten this just a little bit, custom speed. And custom speed. And this looks good. Now I'm copy both effects, both layers, sorry, and place it again. But I have to change the position. And probably I have to make them a little bit larger, yeah. Okay, and now it starts a little bit too late, so I'm going frame by frame. It should start just a little bit earlier, over there, maybe. Yeah, this looks better. Okay, so now, last but not least, sound effects. So, first I have the impact sound effect, and then I have another one, a whoosh. But the one which we should take is probably the impact. Okay, this is a bang and so that's a very strange noise in the beginning. I think I will cut this one out. Yeah.
Have you guys seen Peter McKinnon's awesome time travel app video?
Okay, then takes another impact sound effect for the second explosion. The whoosh is directly in the good position here, good ending. But we can also change the sound effects and lay a whoosh over the impact. Just start a little bit earlier. Okay, and that was it, really easy. Let's see it again.
Have you guys seen Peter McKinnon's awesome? Have you guys seen Peter McKinnon's awesome time travel app video?
And that's it. Very simple, effective, and just done with two smoke layers and two sound effects. What we can do now, for example, is find adjustment layer, put this over the footage and take a LUT, put this over the footage and choose a Osiris LUT and put this on 50%. Okay, and now this is without LUT, this is with LUT. This is the Osiris M31 LUT for cinematic look and feel. And another effect we could use in this case is a handheld effect, because this is very static, because the camera is on a tripod on the floor, and you could choose a handheld effect. And this way it would look as someone would hold the camera.
Have you guys seen Peter McKinnon's awesome time travel app video?
And this would make it look a little bit more natural handheld. But just an option. Okay, and that's all. I hope you liked this little tutorial. I will place all the files, the smoke files and the sound effects, in a zip file on our Patreon page, and I hope you can support us a little bit and pledge, even if it's just $1.99, to our Patreon page, and you can download the files from there. See you in the next video.
Have you guys seen Peter McKinnon's awesome time travel app video? And today I'm showing you how to do that effect by yourself. Hey, what's up, buddy?
Hi!
Whoa!